Hi, my name is Alan Lushansky. I'm an intern on the Android team at Google, and today I'll be talking about some of the various methods you can use to animate fragments. So today I'm going to discuss a few different things, including how you can animate the switch between one fragment and another using Fragment Transaction. I'll talk about how you can create animations using object animators to animate those fragments, as well as a couple of very useful callbacks in fragments that you can use to create very custom animations for your fragment transitions. So jumping straight at the demo, you can see here we have just an image, and this is a fragment that only contains an image. Tapping on it, it slides into the background and pops up another fragment. So this here is just another fragment containing text about the Golden Gate Bridge, which is our original image. Tapping once again, slides that back out. So looking at it once again, tapping once, slides it back in and into the background, has this kind of dimming effect where it darkens it, brings out the text fragment, and tapping once again, slides out the text fragment, dims out that dark hover view, and animates the image fragment back out. So jumping straight into the code, there's a few different things to note here today. Firstly, there's some boilerplate code. We set up a click listener to switch the fragments every single time we click on the screen. And in switch fragments, the first thing you want to look at is here. So I create a listener at the end of which we're going to do the actual fragment transition. So I start a new transaction, and I call this method called setCustomAnimations. What setCustomAnimations does is take in four animator resource files that you can use to animate one fragment in, animate it out, and as well as when you're popping the stack for the fragment transaction, you can also pass the resource files for animating the other fragment in and out. What you have to note here, though, is that I am passing in resource files for the text fragment sliding up and down, but I'm passing in zeros for the image fragment that I'm animating, because that's a little more custom. Then I add my text fragment onto my stack. I set that to null, and I commit my animation. So what this lets me do is later simply pop my fragment manager stack, and then my image fragment will come back up after the text fragment is animated out. So all of this is done at the end of an animation listener, and if you go here to slide back, that's where it's actually going to get executed. So I set up a few animations for the image fragment. I'm going to rotate it about the x-axis. I'm going to scale it so it rotates in the background, then scales and becomes a little smaller. And what I'm actually going to do as well is this mdark hover view, which is just a view with an opacity less than one and a black background color, it's gonna fade in over my image fragment. So one of the things that you can do with set custom animations is add animations to other widgets or other items that you have on the screen. Using this method, you can actually add animations at the same time as the fragment is animated, except to things that may be completely separate from the fragment itself. Once I set up all my animations, I add a start delay such that what's actually going to happen is after I animate the image fragment into the background, only then will the text fragment come back up. And then at the end of that animation, that's when the fragment popping and transaction actually happens. So if you keep sliding back down, there's a method called slide forward. And slide forward actually gets called right here. So what happens is when you click on the screen when the text fragment is in focus, what we're going to do is pop the stack in order to bring the image fragment back in focus. And when the back stack is changed, we're going to call slide forward. In slide forward, we're doing almost the exact same thing as what we did in slide back. We're rotating about the x-axis back out. We're scaling our image fragment back up, and we're fading out the dark hover view instead of fading it in. All of this is then put together using an animator set, and that's how the animation takes place. So this is what you can do if you want to have a custom object animator and set custom animations. But the other important thing that I really wanted to note was in any fragment, there's a callback method you can override called onCreateAnimator. And the thing about onCreateAnimator is it's a method that gets called when you want to get the animation object for a fragment transaction. It has a few useful parameters you can use. But the key behind this is that you can essentially create any custom animation you want here and never be limited just to doing things in an animated resource file. So if we actually just take a quick look at the resource file that we passed into set custom animations, they're right here. we set up an object animator with a from value, a to value, a property name, and a duration. But one of the things I did here is I created a custom property called y fraction. And the reason I did this is because unlike in Vue, in older Vue and tween animations, property animations are independent of what the container actually is. So if, for example, in tween animations, you could tell a Vue to animate from 0 to 100% of its parent's width, we can't do this with property animation. And I found a workaround for this by using y fraction. So in text fragment, there's a custom property. There's a in fractional linear layout, which is actually there's a custom property called y fraction. And so what happens when you create an object animator that animates the property y fraction, it's going to look for a setter called set y fraction. And given the setter right here, set y fraction, what I'm doing is animating a float value between 0 and 1. But since in runtime I can determine what the width and height of my screen is, I can actually just do some simple arithmetic and animate it from 0 to some certain percentage of its parent's container. So those are some different ways of animating fragments, as well as a way to work around not having percent animations with object animators, unlike you did in older Vue animations. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks.